Tandoor. What? A curry? Tandoori.
Not quite.
Tandoor sounds like tandem, so I feel like
it sounds, it sounds Indian as in tandoori, maybe in general. I don't know. What's tandoori named after?
Sorry, taking that into account.
A town? Or a type of cooking?
Well, you shouldn't have got coronavirus, Ian. That's your fault. Question 9 again. What is a tandoor? T-A-N-D-O-O-R.
T-A-N-D-O-O-R.
Of course, it's Tim with the omega.
Indian door.
Very toxic person.
I actually think tandoor is just Indian word for chicken, isn't it?
No, because it's tandoori chicken.
Okay, and question 10. Final question, general knowledge.
Tandoori is like
a chicken. Which leader was assassinated by her own bodyguard on the 31st of October,
1984?
By her own bodyguard on the 31st of October,
1984.
I was worried that this quiz would be too difficult. Everyone's like, Diana. Oh no, we'll be angry if it's too easy. So this is what you get. No. This is the difficulty level. So this is what I'm setting.
Who was it actually? One of the famous French, what's it called? Like
Diana. Oh my god.
At the time, but...
Diana. I need more wine. Right. First off, does anyone want me to repeat any questions? There are no half marks. There is
random
questions. You can go back to them.
Leader.
None specifically, just want to hear more of your voice. Okay, Mazrim. Flattery doesn't work.
A female leader.
And there are no half marks. Female half leader. Mark. If I see anyone with a half mark, their entire team will be disqualified. You're the best alien actor ever, Uwu.
Can't even think of a leader who was
Who is Robert Galbraith, man?
If you don't have Titanic sister ships, then you get zero. Is Matt back? Zero. Oh, we don't. Who cares? So, round two is, of course, Rise and Shine Gamers.
I can't think of a female leader in the 1980s, except Thatcher. That's the only one I can think of.
Half marks, all right. Evan, fuck it off. This isn't some fucking under nines quiz. In 2010, the League of Legends World Finals, Fnatic beat AAA. But who was the mid laner for AAA?
Wasn't Ocelot, was it?
That question again. Who was the mid laner for AAA in the 2010 World Finals?
I don't know.
I say worlds in the most liberal sense of the world. When, you know, it didn't include Korean teams, but we take those. Because obviously Fnatic won, and we're the best team in the world, so what can I say? For sure the best team in Europe. How are you expecting to know this, Ying? Well, it's just general knowledge, isn't it? Bad quiz. Just you wait till we get to the Dota round.
Who do you think it actually is?
I have no idea.
Question two.
I need to turn Felix down. He's way too loud.
Name me the DPS duo from the 2018 London Spitfire roster who won the inaugural season of the Overwatch League.
Don't do Overwatch. Don't do Overwatch.
Phil, and answer your question. It's hosted in Freak's Basement. Guys, I can't just ask you League of Legends questions. Otherwise, you know, everyone knows League of Legends questions. So it doesn't differentiate between the real nerds and the giga nerds. I'll give you a hint, Hutan, it was not XQC. Yan Yang, can you just do the quiz rather than posting? DPS duo, it's two players. The duo, no, not the heroes, the players.
No, not the heroes.
Names of the players. Gross. Yes, Hutan, it was Gross and Gore, that duo of players. So, question number three.
Sorry.
Hold on. There we go. Question number three. In Pokemon, what TM is TM number 32?
Double team. Oh, no, you're right. Yeah, it's Pokemon, I think.
Double team sounds right.
Wait, was that number two? That's three.
Question number four. Which famous artist contributed to the Sonic 3 soundtrack, but ended up abandoning the project and getting no credit? He was uncredited because he abandoned the project. But what was his name?
I was actually going to write Hamza for fun.
Well, he worked on the project, he just wasn't credited in the credits of the game.
Jesus
fucking Christ. Actually, Twitch chat should go true, despite it just being the most stupid message, my word. Why is this so hard? Question number five. What are Singe, Lulu, and Vi passives? Go. Told you to revise your champion passives. You better have done it.
No,
the names of their passive abilities.
Slipstream is Singe.
Slipstream. I remember doing this before.
Slipstream.
And while you think that, I just want to bring up the complaint.
No,
Vi is passive ability is an active ability, and that really pisses me off.
Vi is Blast Shield.
Oh yeah, Blast Shield, yeah.
Singed, Lulu, and Vi.
You type it in.
That is Singed, Lulu, and Vi.
Lulu is
anyway, going back to
the fairy companion.
It really, really tilts me. It's an active ability with a cooldown. It's not a passive. Anyway.
Passive is called Picks the Fairy Companion.
Oh, okay.
Question five again. Singed, Lulu, and Vi passives. That's Vi. V-I. Vi is in the punchy lady with big gauntlets. V-I. That is not Roman numerals for six. That is the champion Vi.
I was about to say that.
Anyway, question six. In 2013, a cosmic dragon champion was previewed. Years later, this became our beloved Aurelion Sol. But what was the name teased for this champion? Yes, Ian, it's question six.
Ocean.
Yes, Ian, it's question six.
Nice.
Which question have you missed, Ian? Okay. And now, why do I have ASMR? Do I? I shouldn't have background noise. I apologise if I do. Oh, is it me? Question six was, in 2013, a cosmic dragon champion was previewed. 3 years later, this became Aurelion Sol. What was the teased name for this champion?
Are you serious?
Question number seven. In 2016, which Counter-Strike Global Offensive player was rated number one by HLTV?
2016.
Oh, Yanning wants out? I'll guess I'll remove the CSGO questions. 2016. 2016.
I
think it was Kevin De Bruyne, actually. Yeah. Which CSGO player was rated number one in HLTV in 2016? Neymar for sure. Question number eight. If I were to use the Guardian Angel ability in Dota 2, what hero would I be playing?
It's Mercy. That's my.
Once again, for the people at the back. If I were to use the Guardian Angel ability in Dota 2, what hero would I be playing?
Oh, wait, Dota 2? I got no buttons.
We'll just keep it. We have no answer for it anyway.
Question Question number 9. At the 2019 Dota International, which hero had the most games played at the main event?
Who gives a fuck about Dota?
Which hero
had the most games played at the
main event? Because that's too complicated. Meepo. Dan, fuck off.
I don't know. Does Meepo get played?
Just put it in, because I have no better guess. Yeah, I was thinking Pudge, but that's just a meme.
Yeah, this is a video game round. Pudge is the only champion you know.
I don't
know.
Justin, me too. Pro play champions are.
Question number 10. The final question of Rise and Shine Gamers. In Mario Kart DS, how many characters are there total that are playable? Question 10 again. In Mario Kart DS, how many characters are there in total that are playable? How
many
characters
are? Any clue? I think there's 16.
No, it doesn't, because it's Mario Kart DS, not Mario Kart Wii.
What was the one you said was the most played one for Dota?
I don't know. I literally just guessed Meepo, because that's one of the few champs I know in
Dota. Mario Kart DS, not Mario Kart Wii.
Wait, you say M-double-E.
It doesn't matter, because we mark
now
ourselves.
Now we've had two rounds. Do we want to do the answers for... Oh, wrong one. It's this one. There we go. I should definitely not be looking at my DMs. Okay. Oh, do all quiz then answers. Okay.
Do all quiz then answers. Okay.
They have to be... What do you mean by pickable always? That is both ones that are unlocked at the start and ones you unlock by completing races. Can we have the questions for round two? Yes. That includes the unlockable ones. Yes. Obviously. That includes the unlockable.
Probably about 24 then. I don't actually know.
Unlockable characters. You know what I mean. Unlockable characters. Who's spamming? Characters. Oscar, for fuck's sake.
Oscar.
What's the secret quest? What? Guys, I have a time save hack. Yeah. Do you want me to just post the entire fucking quiz and then you guys can just go jack off in your own teams? Nice. Yeah, you're right, that's not fun.
Nice. Yeah, you're right, that's not fun.
Okay, so round number 3 is STEMistry, because everyone complained when I had a history round and no STEM questions. So the format for this round
because no one gives a shit about
is we have one question from science and then one question from history. So, does everyone understand?
History.
Question number 1 of round number 3. The chemical symbol Sg is what element?
Alright, we literally have two chemistry
questions. Oh, seaborgium.
This is a science question.
I was going to say, I literally have a periodic table next to me.
I did, because that's like chemistry, do you get it? But it's STEM.
That's like chemistry. But nobody gives a shit about the, like, that level though.
You're right.
That is, you have double M-chem. Question number 2. Name any 3 of the 5 D-Day landing beaches.
Name any 3 of the 5 D-Day landing beaches.
Any of the 3? There was...
Is it the
Creed?
You are not Nico, you don't just get to put Omaha. Creed for
everything. Is Omaha in France? Or
how
that...
do you spell? I think that's one.
I missed that.
Question number 2 again. Name any three of the 5 D-Day landing beaches.
Yeah, it was, yeah. Oh, nice check.
Now, question
just
number 3.
General knowledge.
What is the smallest bone in the...
What is the smallest
sorry,
bone?
I think it's because I'm fiddling with my mic stand. There we go. I'll do that.
Yeah, fill in the last
question. There are no third points. You need three or nothing. If you get all five, you get nothing more than naming three. Question number three. What is the smallest bone in the human spinal column called? Wow, that is a truly blessed picture.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, Oscar actually asks a good question. For Mario Kart on DS, Shy Guy does not count. I want the other, the unlockable characters and playable characters, not the Shy Guy you play as when you do local play. I should have cleared that up. That's my bad. I apologize profusely. Excellent question, Oscar. Wait, did you see that? What the fuck? Oh, is that Oscar? Oh, whoops. Whoopsie. Ah, you're all the same to me. Anyway, where were we? We were on question number four, right? So question number four. Name me the first three American presidents.
Name me the first three American presidents.
Abraham Lincoln. George Washington.
That question again. The first. What were the names of the first three American presidents?
What were the names of the first three American presidents?
Lincoln. Did you know JFK's middle name actually stands for to pay respects?
JFK's middle name actually stands for to pay respect.
Question number five. Which animal's name comes from the Dutch for earth pig? That is earth pig. Which animal's name comes from the Dutch for earth pig?
Vaguely.
Question number six. What was the name of the 1783 treaty that formally ended the American Revolutionary War?
Yo.
Question six again. What was the name of the 1783 treaty that formally ended the American Revolutionary War?
American.
You can't just say women lol.
Double-A-R-D-V-A-R-K.
It's pretty toxic.
It's like the, isn't it like famous, like fucking first word in the alphabet?
That's also pretty toxic.
So everyone knows Aardvark. Oh.
What was six again?
Okay. Question number seven. What is the largest moon of Saturn called?
What is the largest moon of Saturn called?
Titan.
Yeah.
Thanks. Question number seven again. What is the largest moon of Saturn called? Question number eight. What was the American codename for the development of the atom bomb? Question number eight again. What was the American codename for the development of the atom bomb?
Yeah.
That's actually what I do know.
Question number nine. In what part of the body is the occipital bone? That question again. In what part of the body is the occipital bone? That is OCCIPITAL. What part of the body? I mean, I'll give you a hint. The answer I'm expecting is not that specific. It's what part of the body. Is that the one that... Yan Yang, what happened to you? Like, you've never been normal, but this is really extra even for you. Question number 10. Which famous battle is depicted in the Bayeux Tapestry?
Oh.
Battle of Hastings.
Yeah, that's actually
question number 10 again. Question. Which famous battle is depicted in the Bayeux Tapestry?
We need 6.
Just in World War 1, it's not a battle, it's a war.
We need 2 more for 4. But...
battle, it's a war.
It's not the Siege of Vienna. Oh dear. Oh boy. You guys are in for a fucking treat next round. Harry and Matt, if you don't get 10 out of 10 on this the sports round, I'm going to be really disappointed.
Now, I do play cricket, but my cricket knowledge is pretty poor, to be honest.
Okay. Is everyone ready to move on to round number 4?
Wait, what was 6? The treaty that ended the revolution, the American Revolution.
Sorry, is it not meant to be capitalized? My apologies. Yeah, you can exclamation mark it all you want, degens. Anyway, question 1 of round 4, which is sports, yes, real sports. In Football World Cups, who is the highest goal scorer? That is, which player scored the most goals in Football World Cups?
Closer. Mario Closer.
Miroslav Closer.
What do you mean Miroslav. Any country? It's one... It's total in any country. Masrim, leave. Just leave. Just leave. D-gen.
How do I spell his name?
Ah, yeah, I think it was Ying, actually.
Oh, well,
leave
Mark around, that's fine.
Question number 2. Moving swiftly on. Name any of the England front rows from the 2003 World Cup winning squad.
I wanted to say.
A question again. Name any of the England front rows from the 2003 World Cup winning squad. Anyone. So I had this question I heard in another pub quiz, and it was name all 5 of the England front 5, but I thought that might be a bit difficult for you. For anyone wondering, this is a rugby question. Sorry, I should have made that clear. Not everyone knows that England won the Rugby World Cup in 2003. Name any of the front rows from the England squad from 2003 who won the Rugby World Cup. Question number 3. For how many weeks in total was Lee Chong Wei badminton world number 1?
Oh, this is like 200 weeks.
Our flankers front row. Kieran? No. The front row is prop, hooker, prop.
The front row is prop, hooker, prop.
I mean, I do want the exact number of weeks, to be honest, but... What do you mean, Yan Ying?
Yan Ying, you know about badminton.
He was world number 1 total.
He said 200 weeks.
No. So he was 200 weeks after he got banned, but before that, he was like 100.
Question 3 again. For how many weeks in total was Lee Chong Wei world number 1 in badminton?
349.
I actually didn't know he had a doping ban. I know he had a bad injury. I didn't realize he was banned for doping. That's pretty unfortunate.
Yeah, he was banned in 2012. That's something I do know.
Really? Wow. Question number four. In 2010, the longest game of tennis ever was played between Mahu and Isner.
9 hours.
How long, or how many games, was the final set? Or what was the score in the final set, rather?
Oh, it was like 50.
That is, in 2010, the game between Mahu and Isner,
it was like...
how many games were there in the final set? Or what was the score?
It was like... it was under 50. Like 50.
What are we counting down to? Happy New... wait, hold on a second.
50? 48?
You can only play one game. You're right, Justin. It's one game and it's tennis.
Right, Justin. It's one game and it's tennis.
Question number five.
No.
Pakistan's top top test wicket taker is who? Who is Pakistan's top wicket taker in Test matches? Who is Pakistan's top
wicket taker in Test matches? I don't know. I know
what
who
sport
their best
is Pakistan? This is a cricket question for anyone wondering.
This is a cricket question.
What is Pakistan? What about quick cricket? What about quick cricket, Chen?
What about
Question number five. Again, who is Pakistan's top test wicket taker? I'm realistic. I may as well just ask fucking Harry and Matt these questions. Question number six. Sachin Tendulkar is India's leading test match run scorer. But who is their second highest test match run scorer?
Wow, I really know these.
You mean the one I said I was repeating?
That's like the only Indian player I knew.
Who's this question was that, number six? Retard? These are not easy. Matt, if you don't get these, I'll be disappointed. Question number seven. In the decathlon, what is the final event? Everyone knows 2005 Ashes. I don't want it to be easy. What is the 10th event in the decathlon?
Final event in the decathlon. What is it? Anyone know? Before I guess.
Question number eight. In skiing, what is another name for cross-country racing?
I was going to say it's cross-country, but...
I'm glad you deleted that, Yan Yang.
Why, what did Yan Yang put?
Taste it, Yan Yang, I didn't read all of it.
Ying, you went to Maudlin. Question number nine. Which teams would you find playing in the Turin Derby? What teams would you find playing in the Turin Derby?
That is what I do know. Inter and AC Milan.
Well, surely not. Inter and AC Milan are based in Milan, right?
Oh, Turin. What am I doing? It's Juventus. Lamau. I'm actually retarded.
Who else is in Turin other than Juventus?
Question number 10. In snooker, to make a break of 147, how many consecutive shots must you hit?
How many consecutive shots must you hit?
Red, black, red, black, red.
Question again. In snooker, to make a break of 147, how many consecutive shots must you hit?
10, 15, 30, and then...
All of them is not a valid answer.
Let's see.
While technically correct, it is not a valid answer. I want to know how many. What number?
I think I
want to
say 14.
How many consecutive shots must you hit?
If you get 147, you need to plot all the reds and all the blacks. You need to plot all... That's already 30.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
37, I think.
37.
Or is it 20? Are there 10 or 15?
Right.
It's 10 reds, I think.
Then it's 27. Was that number 10?
The questions. We're going to take a quick break now while people like me go and refill their drinks. Coming up next is round 5, and that is the music round. So, I'll put some music on you for you while we all wait. I say, as my Spotify doesn't work.
Hello?
This could be an issue.
I was about to say it's... That bloody
my fucking headset actually turned off because it was idle for so long. What the fuck? Oh, you know what we should play instead of this rubbish?
Turin Torino.
Yes, Torino.
Torino.
But they're irrelevant. So, enjoy. Master to master, back to back. Four different roles on the pack. Koki and I were the silver backs. Justin's been in bot. Asthma attack. Man said he'd name drop Oscar and Benuxus. Who the fuck are these no name losers? May as well be Tweedledum and D. Cracking your skulls. Humpty Dumpty, don't get me started. E fan. Emo is inflated. Dirty con man. Do a boost by Justin all night and day. Leaves your boy wondering how does he pay. Justin likes it.
Did he just sound Asian to say Justin?
Cause he's upper class. To a new boy's private school. Touches little kids in the swimming pool. Justin looks like he's made a wish. Thank God he lives on summoners. Studies Max's quads 15 hours a day. Is there anyone in Bristol that might not be gay? Evan used to have a girlfriend. Met when parents' evening came to an end. My man's already caught gonorrhea. Now he's stuck with yellow fever. Can't spell long stuff without FF. He's added an extra one for the deaf. 6-season diamond player. Only really known as the Ember Slayer. Who even is Benuxus? Where's Einstein? Tarek's own abuser. This replacement is fucking terrible. Benuxus and Evan. That's unbearable when I say Evan. You say nonce. Heaven.
Nonce.
Evan.
Nonce.
When I say Bristol. You say bad. Bristol bad. Bristol bad. Alright boys, I'll end it here. Don't want to plot it like last year. Make sure you remember the classic line.
You was the one who actually had the good track. There was one of them, like, somebody had a really good one. Who was it? Ah. It was him. It was sent your isolation. Send.
I said I didn't know if I could do this, guys, but after our 2 losses on Sunday, I just had to. Who's here for dissing? There would be a track to. Big love to Max Lee, dedicated to you. Support has been joked on, but here is the truth. I will be carrying, and here is the proof. Mid lane dying, 2 ganks from a danger call. Why do I play with brains that are so small? Top lane is splitting without all those pinks. I'll buy all that AP so team fights don't stink. My vision is stopping this bot lane from flopping, but marked, not harassing, without me asking. The enemy is on a spree. Oh fuck me, I'll cue it, I'll ignite it, I'll root it, I'll call it. 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 You see my skill? Here you go. Easy kill. I'll cue it, I'll ignite it, I'll root it, I'll call it. Mid game is different where I'm not in lane jail. Maxed out on pink wars, now time for some real teal. Buying that M pen but can't fight all inting. Max limit testers is only meant for scrimming. The team banned fresh pike and blitz is a hate. Not scared of hooking and fisting, can't relay. Macro is the key to winning this null game. My monkey teammates can't follow, what a shame. Top lane is TPing. Tom Kench is eating. Mid lane is ganking. LeBlanc ain't flanking. Where is my AD? Jungle invading. Just follow. I'll flash it. I'll root it. I'll call it. I'll root it. I'll call it.
Wait,
I'll
what the fuck?
It. I'll call it. I'll root it. I'll call it. I'll root it. I'll call it. James Yule, the Carthus. One button. Just R it. I'll cue it. I'll ignite it. I'll root it, I'll call it. See, this is the part where it's all wrong. Late game Nash calls got me all done. Risking 50-50, are you nuts? About to hand them our extra butts. Death timer has started and I am broken hearted. Got me back thinking to the early game that I was flashing them roots and in that juicy loot, perking them too. Praise for being woo, hearing them yelling boo. Look at my kills, look at my deaths. KDA higher than everyone else. The vision score, I'm a impeccable threat. I'm not even breaking a sweat. I'll root it, I'll call it. 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 Ethereal Chainscroft. Just land it. I'll cue it, I'll ignite it. I'll root it, I'll call it. Sorry guys. But it had to be done.
That was like the politest track I've ever read, like listened to. No, please.
Okay. How's everyone doing? Everyone got a drink? Everyone ready?
Everyone got a drink.
For the music round. That's right. That's what's happening. It's the music round.
Oh,
everyone's
fuck.
Favorite, right? Everyone
Wait.
Loves music. So. There are two halves to this music round. I hope you're all vaguely listening.
Wait, how is he
going to
play it
and
I'll show it to us?
You're all going
to
do horribly. Oh, that's the wrong one. Why do I have... I have two tabs called quiz. And one is that and one is the actual quiz. Justin, you drank too much water. Okay, so... The first five questions, I am going to play you a song. And I need you to tell me what song is sampled. In that, what track is sampled in that song? So, I'll say that again.
So,
I'm going to play you a song, and you have to tell me what track is sampled in that
song. And you have to tell me what track is sampled in that song.
That will be the first five, and then the second five, I will play you a song, and I need the song name and the artist. Okay. Does anyone not understand? So, I'm going to play you the first five songs I will play you.
I'm going to play you the first five songs
I need
you
to tell me what song is sampled in that song.
Tell me what song is sampled
in that song. And then after that, it'll be quite very simple. I need artists
and
song.
After that, it'll be quite very simple. I need.
Does anyone not know what I mean when I say sampled? We won't judge you for not knowing. I definitely don't think you're a retard if you don't know. Okay, cool, right. We all know what we mean. Let's go. So this is song number one. Let me know if you can't hear it. This song is Rihanna, S.O.S. In case anyone's wondering.
Calling out for help. Ask me someone help.
So that was SOS by Rihanna, and I want you to tell me what song was sampled in that song. What track was sampled in that song?
What track was sampled?
The song or Rihanna? Don't even know what that means. Right.
Banger. I can't
feel it. Question number two. Same thing again. I'm going to play you a bit of Hung Up by Madonna, and I want you to tell me what song is sampled.
Tell me what song is sampled.
Oh, it's Tainted Love, by the way.
Wait, how the fuck do you know that? How are we even questioning it?
I recognize that tune, but I don't
know. Everyone does, but I can't.
Oh! It almost sounds like ABBA.
With this song?
I know. Almost sounds like Give Me a Man After Midnight.
There you go, that was Hung Up by Madonna. I want to know what track is sampled.
That was Hung Up by Madonna. I want to know what.
Next one is Feel This Moment, featuring Christina Aguilera.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
I want to know what track is sampled on it.
Yo, Exipple playing Cricket 19. There, that was Feel This Moment by Pitbull and Christina Aguilera.
Feel This Moment by,
this is a great round, thank you.
Anyone have an answer for that?
Number four is a song by Kanye West, and is Stronger.
Kanye West. Stronger.
Well, that's obviously Harder, Faster, Stronger by Daft Punk.
Harder, better.
Alright, that's enough of Wayne Quest.
I thought he was going to do so, Power for 21st Century Schizoid Man.
Can top rap Tom rap this round? No. That was number four. I'm now going to play number five, which is You Can't Touch This by MC Hammer. I want to know, again, what is sampled?
MC Hammer. You can't touch this. Yeah, what is sampled?
It's the first five, so it's just the.
I want the sampled song.
First five, so it's just sampled.
Sampled song.
There you go. That is the first half of the music round.
There you go. That is.
After this, I just want the name of the song and the artist.
I just want the name of the song and the
artist. It's just song and artist. Super simple.
Okay. Just
song super, super simple. Simple. Okay, this is the first song. There you go. First song. Question. So number seven.
So number seven.
Is this song. Seven. Again, I need song name and artist.
This song. Again, I need song name and artist.
There you go.
That sounds like the artist from the...
Now on to question number 8. I can KDA. Play all these again. But we'll do that at the end. So it's question 8.
Ah. Wait, this is 8. Crocodile Rock. John Lennon. Not John. What the fuck am I saying? Elton John. We ain't got one. Yeah. I mean, it does actually tell it the song, but I won't.
There you go. That was number 8. I'm now going to play you number 9. There are no half points in my quizzes.
There are no half points in my quizzes.
This is Queen, isn't it?
There you go. And now the final question of the music round.
And now,
question number 10.
Final question of the music round. Question number 10.
Fuck.
Imagine me and you. I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me. Lose my mind. Imagine how the world could be so very fine, so happy together.
There we go. That is the end of the music round.
There we go. That.
What do people want me to play again?
What do people want me to play again?
Should I just play? I can just play them all again. So, for the first five, what do you need me to play again?
For the first five.
I see number one. Just go now.
The only thing is, you need okay. both parts. Like,
do people actually want me to play anything again?
Ten is obviously happy together.
I think I saw 7 and 9, right? That was one, Matt. Okay.
7 and 9, right?
You just got
that
it.
That was one, Matt. Okay?
Like 8 seconds of it. 9. Wait. Do you actually need 9? Like actually? Wait. Like really?
Do you actually need 9? Like actually?
Yeah, I'd like 9 again.
That's the thing. I'm pretty sure you all know it, but you just want to hear it again.
I'm pretty sure you all know it, but you just
right.
want
to
hear it.
We can come back to that at the end. On to the right. final round, the last 10 questions of the quiz, which is quite what's like called Quizmaster's Choice. And lucky you guys, you get questions about things I like. This is the difficult round. Everything else has been fairly easy up to now. So, question number one. Which hymn Pokemon. Was written for the tune of Holst's Jupiter? Which hymn was written for the tune of Holst's Jupiter?
I have no idea.
Question number two. Which book by J.R.R. Tolkien tells the entire history of Middle-earth?
Oh, Silmarillion.
Silmarillion, yeah.
Question again. Which book by J.R.R. Tolkien tells the entire history of Middle-earth?
Uncultured, Jamie. Know your Lord of the Rings.
Question number three. Which author finished the Wheel of Time series after Robert Jordan, its original author, passed away? I do not mean the anthology of 12 books that tell the entire history of Middle-earth, I mean the one individual book.
Mr. Sandon Branderson.
Brandon Sanderson.
Question number three again. Which author finished the Wheel of Time series after Robert Jordan, its original author, died?
Wait, what did you say it was?
Brandon Sanderson.
Question number four. In Dungeons and Dragons, what type of creature is Strahd? In Dungeons and Dragons, what type of creature is Strahd? We're thinking of the Strand, Nathan. Strahd. S-T-R-A-H-D. Question number five. Complete the phrase. One ring to rule them all. One ring to find them. One ring to bring them all.
One ring to find them. One ring to bring them all.
And in the darkness, find them. See, how do you know that by the Lord of the Rings and not
once
what
again,
the...
complete the phrase. One ring to rule them all. One ring to find them. One ring to bring them all. Bonus points if you can get me if you give it to me in black speech. Actual bonus point if you can tell me the black speech as well.
Actual bonus point if you can tell me the black speech as well.
Jesus Christ.
Question number six.
Question number six.
Who wrote plays such as The Lysistrata, The Wasps, or The Clouds? Who wrote plays such as Lysistrata, The Wasps, or The Clouds?
The Wasps, or The Clouds?
Question number seven.
Question number
seven. What are the six teams that Martin Reckless Larson has played for in his professional career. If you get all six, you get 3 points. If you get five, you get 2 points. If you get four, you get 1 point. If you get three or less, you get nothing. Once again, that is name the six teams that Martin Reckless Larson has played for. You get 3 marks for six. 5 marks for 2 marks for five, sorry. 1 mark for four, and no marks for three or fewer.
1 mark for four. And no marks for three or fewer.
Well, Fnatic Elements, obviously, it's the obvious two out of the way.
Question number eight.
Was he on?
If you are making buttercream, what two ingredients would you need?
If you are making buttercream, what two ingredients would you need?
If you are making buttercream, what two ingredients would you need?
Buttercream, what two ingredients would you need?
I'd hope it's buttercream.
Once again, if you are making buttercream, what two ingredients would you need?
It might low-key be buttermilk.
Question number nine, the penultimate question of our quiz.
Question number nine, the penultimate question.
Who wrote the hit musical Hamilton?
Who wrote the hit musical Hamilton?
Oh, somebody got a steam indict.
I've been going online on two for the past five.
And once again, question nine. Who wrote the hit musical Hamilton?
Once again, question nine. Who wrote Hamilton?
And question number 10. The final question.
Question number 10.
Of course, nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Of course.
But alongside fear, surprise, fanatical devotion to the Pope, and nice red uniforms, what is their chief? What are their chief weapons? Alongside fear, surprise, fanatical devotion to the Pope, and nice red uniforms.
Is it
guns? Cushions.
There are five chief weapons. I've given you four. What is the fifth?
There are five chief weapons.
Fear, surprise, something, fanatical devotion to the Pope, and nice red uniforms.
Fanatical devotion to the Pope and nice red uniforms.
Fluffy pillows or cuff cushions? I can't remember which one it was. It was a Monty Python reference.
Yeah, it's Monty Python. I don't know what the fourth is. Fifth, sorry.
Oh, the comfy chair.
Comfy chair, alright.
Right. I need to go to the toilet, so I will leave you with some music. And when I come back, we will go through the answers. If you need any more questions, just scroll up, idiots. Trying to let you know,
well, to be honest, I don't think we did particularly well, but oh well. I must let you know. I think I'm gonna have to mute the stream. No, I guess every mouse will spike that.
I'm just still laughing at the actual small picture.
Wait, where's Sue Tenzin?
Yanyang C says hi. Hi, Yanyang. Wutan lived up to expectations. Excellent.
Wutan lived up to expectations.
Okay, so, who is ready for answers? First of all, does anyone want me to go over any of the questions? Yes, we're self-marking.
What
do you mean, are you swapping? No, you're not swapping. You're just answering.
You're just answering.
you just mark your own. It's way too confusing.
You just mark your own. Mark your own.
So, round one.
So.
You know what? I really should have put the questions next to the answers. So that way I could actually see the question. So, the first one was the country named after the Portuguese for bearded ones. That is Barbados.
That is Barbados.
Question two. I believe it was the Siege of Vienna. And that was obviously 1683. So if you had anything between 1673 and 1693, you get the mark.
1693, you get the mark.
Those are inclusive. 1600.
1673 or 1693, you get the mark. Question number three. The brand, formerly known as Dassler, colloquially known as Adi Dassler, is now known as Adidas or Adidas. Known
as Adidas.
Justin, there are no half marks, Justin, buddy.
There are no half marks, buddy.
What was the question? Oh yeah, how many candles are there on a menorah?
Oh yeah, how many candles?
The answer is obviously 9.
Told you.
It's 4, then a
middle. I got my random religious candles confused.
Got one.
Question number 5. YouTube.
Hell fucking
2005.
Yeah.
I told you it was fucking.
Even in Rob. I think in Rob's. Rob, are you 15? I think Rob's 15, right?
Rob, are you 15? I think Rob's 15, right?
Told you 5. Oh, that's so painful. But we get me at the zoo, right?
I mean,
we get a mark for that.
I mean,
I said it was 05.
You know what? If you had 7, I'll allow it. Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah,
sure.
What about 06?
A 9 branch candelabrum, but if you had 7, I'll allow it. Technically, not.
Oh, I've been talking about the.
It's not actually 7. Question number 6. Oh yeah, this was who is Robert Galbraith?
Oh, yeah. Like,
the answer is of course J.K. Rowling. It's J.K. Rowling's pen name.
Oh, it is.
Question number 7. The Titanic's twin sisters were the Olympic and the Britannic. Or the Britannic, rather. Question number 8. The outer part of the sun's atmosphere is of course the corona. Number 9, a tandoor. It's a thing you cook tandoori in, so it's a type of clay oven. Anything along that lines, anything from oven to anything more specific is allowable. It's technically a cylindrical clay oven.
Can we have a chimney? Is that okay?
Number 8 was corona.
Number 8 was corona.
Yeah. Evan, when you said tandoor chicken lol, you were actually on the right lines. I just didn't want to say anything. And number 10, the leader who was killed by her own bodyguard was Indira Gandhi.
Indira Gandhi.
Round number two. The mid laner for AAA in Season 1 World's Finals was MoMA. M-O-M-A. MoMA.
M-O-M-A. MoMA.
Question number 2. The DPS duo for the London Spitfire were Prophet and Birdring. You're thinking of Xpeke, who played top lane for Fnatic, I think, Evan. Question number 3, TM number 32, up to and including Gen 6, is Double Team, the most cancer ability in the game, up there with Minimize.
Yay!
No problem, Max. I was pretty confident you'd be the only other person who'd get that. Maybe Harry, but I don't think he actually follows. Question number 4, In Sonic,
question number four.
Was it Sonic 3? Something Sonic, along those lines. The artist who contributed the soundtrack but abandoned the project was Michael Jackson.
Abandoned the project was Michael Jackson.
Question number five. Singed passive is, of course, Noxious Slipstream. Lily passive is Pix the Fairy Companion. And Vi passive is Blast Shield.
We didn't have Noxious, does that matter?
That is Noxious Slipstream, no, we'll Pix the Fairy Companion, Noxious and Blast Shield.
We need the help.
You need all of them for 1 point.
We got the other two.
All of them for 1 point. I need Noxious Slipstream.
Cool.
Question number six. The Cosmic Question Dragon teased in 2013, who then Dragon would come out as Aurelion Sol 3 years later, was teased under the name Ao Shin. It is A-O space S-H-I-N. Ao Shin.
Ao Shin.
Number seven. The
2016...
Number one CSGO player was Cold Zero.
Number one CSGO player was Cold Zero.
Points, boys!
Question number eight.
Question
if I were to use Guardian Angel in the game of Defense of the Ancients 2, I would be playing Omni Knight.
I would be playing Omni Knight.
Yeah, I...
Oh yeah, at the 2019 TI, the most played hero was... Tiny with 23 games.
Tiny with 23 games.
It was not Io and it was not Pudge.
It was not Io and it was not Pudge.
And question number 10.
And question number 10.
As I think my mistake earlier caused someone to rage, is 12. Shy Guy does not count. There are 8 playable and 4 more unlockable. Round number 3. SG is of course antimony.
SG is of course antimony.
The chemical antimony, or element rather. The
chemical antimony.
SG? Sorry?
Question number 2. You need any three of Utah, Omaha, Gold, Juno, or Sword.
You said SG.
Why am I being helloed? Am I being trolled? Oh, it's SB. I'm actually getting trolled. Okay. In that case, if you put Seaborgium, you can have it.
My
apologies.
DJ.
First time doing this, I'm bound to make mistakes.
If you put Seaborgium
or Antimony, I'll allow it.
Seaborgium or Antimony, I'll allow it.
Hold on. I did say SB, I'm just an idiot. I just can't read. It's like, all the other ones are pretty easy, but it's like, that one's a bit rogue. Everyone knows tungsten.
Everyone knows
lead, everyone knows all of these. Oh well.
Happens.
Beginning
of the song. Just for fun.
That's true. If you put antimony, you're That's a real true. Big smurf. Anyway, where were we? Question two. That was Utah, Omaha, Gold, two, Juno, and Utah, Sword. Omaha, you need any Gold, three of Juno, those for sword. One mark. If you put two, mark. You get nothing. If you put four, you get one mark. If you put five, you get one mark. If you put three, you get one mark.
Five, you get one mark. If you put three, you get one mark.
Question number three is the coccyx. There are no half marks.
There are no half marks.
Put six, as long as you got three of them correct. The first three American presidents were George Washington, John Adams, and Thomas Jefferson.
I feel like I should have known four.
There are no partial marks. You need all of them for one mark. That's true. If you wrote the name of every beach in the world...
If you wrote the name of every beach in the world...
You would, including their code names...
You would,
Question five. The Earth Pig in Dutch is aardvark.
In Dutch is aardvark.
We're hearing Felix three times through echoes.
Question number six.
Question number six.
Excuse me. The treaty that brought to end the American Revolutionary War was the Treaty of Paris.
Was the Treaty of Paris.
That was the Treaty of Paris.
Treaty of Paris.
Question number seven. The largest moon of Saturn is Titan.
The largest moon of Saturn is Titan.
Did we say Titan? I said Titan. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. Somebody said
Question
it.
Number eight. Any Sivers. The American name for the A-bomb project was, of course, the Manhattan Project.
We've actually smashed this round.
Number nine, the occipital bone.
Number nine,
it's in your head.
Occipital bone.
Stop. It sounds like oculus.
Anything more specific than the head?
That's why I said head.
I don't do STEM subjects. Ugh. Disgusting. Back of the head is fine. Anything?
Back of the head is fine.
I assume it's something to do with the eye socket, but given. Wait, really? Why is it called the occipital bone? Anyway,
got a huge
question number 10 was the what battle is depicted on the Bayeux Tapestry? If you don't know this, you disappoint me. It's obviously the Battle of Hastings. You're Latin learner idiot. It was not World War One or World War Two. It's really unlucky.
Well, they got the Battle of Hastings. Fair play.
Round four was, of course, our sports round.
Number one,
player with the highest number of goals at World Cups was Miroslav Klose.
Two was a complete guess. I have no clue where Lawrence Lalu plays.
Question number two. You needed any of Woodman, Thompson, or Vickery.
Where did the law?
Question number three was how many weeks total was Lee Chong Wei world number one? The answer is 349.
Well done, Yang Yang.
Question number four. The marathon game between Mahu and Isner was 70-68 in the final set. That is 138 games total, or 70-68.
I remember a statistic that a flight took off from America and they filmed it going over.
I assume Matt got that. If Matt didn't get that, I'd be disappointed.
Question number five.
The Pakistan fast bowler who's taken the most wickets is Wasim Akram. And the second highest run scorer for India is Rahul Dravid.
Rahul Dravid, rather.
To be fair, I just play cricket. I don't actually have any knowledge of that.
Well, neither does Matt, apparently.
Not yet. One day, maybe. Question number seven. The final event in the decathlon is the 1500 metres.
Oh, fuck. I knew it was... That's sad.
Question number eight. In skiing, another name for cross-country skiing is Nordic skiing.
Never heard of that phrase in my life.
I've heard of that one, actually. I've just forgotten it.
Fair enough.
Question number nine. If you were watching the Turin Derby, you would be watching Torino against Juventus.
Against Juventus.
And question number 10.
And question number 10.
Off-piste. No, you do not get off-piste.
No, you do not get off-piste. Off-piste does not...
You can do any type of skiing off-piste.
You can do any type of skiing.
Cross-country is very difficult. I will give you a hint. AC Milan and Inter Milan, I believe, is known as the Milan Derby, but I don't know for sure. And question number 10, to get a break of 147, so you need to hit 36 consecutive shots.
36.
Yes, but that's not what it's called, Oscar, and I asked for what it's called.
That's not what it's called, Oscar, and I asked for what it's called.
Yeah, man, can we get a pin? Thank you. Okay, onto the music round. We go into...
I've never seen an emote get that many f*** in this show.
So, song one was S.O.S. by Rihanna, and that, of course, samples Tainted Love.
Well played.
Tainted Love.
Tainted Love.
Tainted Love.
Nice one, Barry.
I only need the song name, and I've only written the song name, so I'm afraid I don't remember the artist. I should know the artist for this, but I don't remember off the top of my head. Question two was Hung Up by Madonna.
Question two,
and that, of course, sampled Gimme, 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 open brackets, A Man After Midnight, close brackets, by ABBA. You're allowed... Soft Cell, that's right. Thank you, Barry. Yeah, you are... I will accept Gimme, 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 or A Man After Midnight.
We're going to give ourselves Gimme, Gimme, so I couldn't be fucked right the rest of it.
If you put Gimme, Gimme, you're wrong.
If you put Gimme, Gimme...
Question three... In Feel This Moment by Pitbull featuring Christina Aguilera, you of course hear Take On Me by Aha!
You of course hear Take On Me by Aha!
Everyone heard that right? And then question five.
Question five.
Oh no, question.
You don't
sorry, that was question three. Question four now. Stronger by Kanye. Wayne Quest, sorry. Stronger features, of course, Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger by Daft Punk.
Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger.
Not features, fuck, wrong word. Samples. My apologies.
Samples.
From a.
And then question five.
And then question five.
You Can't Touch This by MC Hammer.
You Can't Touch This by MC Hammer. Of course.
Samples Super Freak by Rick James.
Should have known that. What's that?
Question number six. That was the lovely Swedish power metal song we heard about the D-Day landings. And that was Primo Victoria by Sabaton.
Primo Victoria by Sabaton.
Did anyone know that? Does anyone here listen to Sabaton?
Did anyone know that?
Mickey knows it. Nice.
Did anyone know that? Nice.
Sabaton are fantastic, by the way.
Fantastic.
You should all go listen to Sabaton. It's really, really good. Question number seven was, of course, Up and Down by XID.
Up and Down by XID.
Question number eight. Question number eight was, of course, Crocodile Rock by Elton John.
Crocodile Rock by Elton John.
I just couldn't think of the Queen song for nine.
Yeah.
Can't think of the title.
Question number nine. Again.
Question number
these two were absolute gimmies. Question number nine was, of course,
gimmies.
The Seven Seas of Rye by Queen.
The Seven Seas of Rye by Queen.
Oh, I'm so sad without.
And then finally, question number 10 was
question number 10 was
Happy Together by The Turtles.
Happy Together by The Turtles.
Ying, there are no half points, so no.
Ying, there are no half
there
points,
are,
so no.
Half points do not exist.
Half points
absolutely
do not,
not
exist. Absolutely not.
No, you do not get half points.
No, you do not get half points.
Disgusting players. And then, of course, on to my favourite round, the Quizmaster's Choice. Question one. Houtan, if you want to make a petition for half points, if it gets 100 signatures, I'll do half points next round, next time, if I do another one. Okay? So, question number one. The hymn based on the tune of Holst's Jupiter is I Vow to Thee. That is I Vow to Thee. You're right, Matt. It's not Jerusalem. You're really right, correct. Question number two.
Question number two.
The single book by J.R.R. Tolkien. That details the entire world of Middle-earth from creation to the return of the Eldar to the West is the Silmarillion. Question number three. The author who finished the Wheel of Time series is Brandon Sanderson. After Robert Jordan passed away, Brandon Sanderson finished off the series. Question number four. In D&D, Count Strahd is a vampire.
He is a vampire.
He didn't say Count to begin with, did he?
Question five.
Yeah, it's probably intentional.
The phrase, one ring to rule them all, one ring to find them, one ring to bring them all, and in the darkness bind them. You needed, and in the darkness bind them. The vampire is the only acceptable answer, and no, I didn't say count. Thought it'd be too easy if I did that. And the black speech is Ashnaz Durbatuluk, Ashnaz Gimpatul, Ashnaz Hrakatuluk, Ash Burzum Ishi Krimpatul.
No, he just sounds like the people on the skirt.
Oh, you want me to say that again? Sorry. That was Ashnaz Durbatuluk, Ashnaz Gimpatul, Ashnaz Hrakatuluk, Ash Burzum Ishi Krimpatul. Question number six. The author of The Lysistrata, The Wasps and the Clouds, amongst other plays, is Aristophanes. That's all I needed, was Aristophanes. Question number seven. Martin Reckless Larson has played for Pride, Playing Ducks, Copenhagen Wolves, Elements, Alliance, and Fanatic. If you had four of those, you get one. If you had five, you get two. If you had six, you get three. The thing, I expected most of you, I expected pretty much all of you to get four, but I expected no one to get five. Fanatic Beta do not count, they are technically Fanatic and technically Fanatic Academy. Bear with me one second. Sorry, that was of course the perfect time for my mother to come into my room. Question number eight. To make buttercream, you of course need butter and sugar. What else would it be? Question number nine. Yes, icing sugar is a type of sugar. No, butter and cream will not be accepted because it's not butter and cream. It's butter and sugar. The person who wrote hit musical Hamilton was, of course, Lin-Manuel Miranda. That is Lin-Manuel, space Miranda. And question number 10, the chief weapons of the Spanish Inquisition, something none of you expected, are, of course, fear, surprise, ruthless efficiency, fanatical devotion to the Pope, and nice red uniforms. For anyone who doesn't know, that's from a very famous Monty Python sketch.
Oh, what it was.
And is a big meme, and also Harry's name. And Harry's name is the reason I put this in the quiz. Because it would be a nice surprise for the end of the quiz. Right, I would like teams to input their answers, smiley face.
Input their answers, smiley face.
1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 12.
Oh god.
15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Where's the document?
The lower bracket is a great place to make a name for yourself as a less experienced wife, because obviously in the bracket.
Is he watching me on the fucking...
I believe there are a total of possibly 63 points you could have won. I think there was
63 points you could have won.
Wait, what's this one?
I have.
No! Justine!
Justine. Are all these scores accurate?
Are all these scores accurate?
I believe we are shorter team, no?
We
have Big Hair, Bigger Nose, Amaranth's Tier 3 subs, DDoS Third File dot Bat, Angel Archer's Tier 3 subs, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, etc. And then, is there a Team 5 under here? No, that's just Sound 1 and Cliff Bar. Who are, what are Team 5? Because I struggle to believe you got 10 in every round and then 0 in the final round. Really, just delete some of these. Abominations. What is this? Oh my god, it's positive for once.
Oh my god, it's positive for once.
Aha. Aha.
So, are all these...
Okay, whoever keeps putting things up, can you not?
Oh, Jesus.
Are all these scores accurate?
Are all these scores accurate? Because if so, I will...
Jesus
Christ. Okay. Oh, you're all anonymous users, aren't you? I can't even tell who's doing it.
Oh, you're all the worst. Thanks for watching this video, guys.
Really unhappy,
special thanks to my Patreon subscribers, and they will be.
Wait, Matt got 2 out of 10 in the sports round? What? Fuck's sake, man. Aha. Oh, for fuck's sake, man.
So.
In joint fourth place, we have
Big Hair
and Bigger Nose.
Jesus
fucking Christ. This is impossible, isn't it?
See what
is happening. This fucking document. You've absolutely just violated it.
So
I will ask again.
Are these scores
all absolutely correct? Before I read out all your mediocre quiz names, honestly. I'm disappointed in all of you, by the way.
Hold on.
Do I want to leak my DMs?
So
in joint last place, first loser is a big hair, bigger nose with 27, and team up five, https://www.twitch.tv/chentang_clip/better-magnificent-donkey-humble-life, who also got 27.
Then
in
third place
we have Amaranth's tier 3 subs with 33 points. In second place is team 4, Angel Archers, tier 3 subs, exclamation mark, etc.
And
the winners of it all
are team
3,
DDoS 3rd
file.bat with 38 points. To be honest, I'm kind of impressed. I expected people to be getting more like 30, between 20 and 25 and 35. I didn't expect people to get much more than that. So well done, guys.
I'm really proud of you.
You know?
Right.
And that's the end of the quiz.
So I hope. I hope everyone enjoyed it.
If you want me to do this again,
I think I can.
I might do a shorter one and do it same time next week. If people are interested.
Okay.
Well, that's at least two positive things. So excellent. Balance the team. I thought the teams were fairly balanced, to be honest, and I think the scores were fairly reasonable. But I swear to God, if anyone ever defiles my sheet like
this
again. Disgusting. Right. With that, I will see you all in.